Chris Welli stellt zur NAB-Show 2017 EDIUS 8.5 vor. Wir haben in unserem EDIUS-Podcast bereits die einzelnen Neuerungen vorgestellt. Kann also dort die einzelnen Funktionen, die dazugekommen sind, wie zum Beispiel H265 Support, Unterstützung für die GH5-Kamera beispielsweise oder auch erweiterter Metadaten-Support, besseres und schnelleres H264-Encoding und die weiteren neuen Funktionen sich im Detail anschauen. Und hier bei mir ist jetzt Alex, der Produktmanager von EDIUS, und ich werde ihn ein bisschen fragen, was hier auf der NAB-Show sonst noch rund um EDIUS gezeigt wird. Alex.
Okay, so we're showing here version 8.5, and as you mentioned, with the new functionalities, PQ support in the primary color correction, also updated the H.264 codec on the encoding side, also support for the new Panasonic GH5 cameras, support for the H.265 files coming from them. And so we're showing a demo here with a monitor capable of showing the HDR output from the EDIUS timeline, so you can also see the PQ setting. We're also showing some new stuff.
Yeah, I've seen a MacBook on the EDIUS booth. What does that mean?
So this is, unfortunately, it's not EDIUS running on a Mac, but it's actually EDIUS on cloud. So this is basically EDIUS running on the Amazon Workspace. It's running on a virtual machine instance on the cloud, and we're accessing to the system via regular internet line to the data center, and we're accessing such as like a remote desktop on the MacBook screen. But you can see the actual performance, but the actual performance is it's very good, and you can feel it almost as though you're editing on the laptop locally. So yeah, it's something that we're showing people that it's there and the technology is coming, and what is actually being could be provided in the near future.
Yeah, I mean, cloud computing is of course a big topic also here at NAB Show. In the last weeks, there has another product has been introduced, the XRE Transcoder. Is it also shown here?
Yes. So we're showing the XRE Transcoder actually at the Stratus booth right next door, where we are using XRE Transcoder as a gateway of importing multiple different types of files into Stratus in a Stratus native format.
So the transcoder is a product on its own normally. How is it typically used? What does it do?
So the XRE Transcoder is basically EDIUS running as an engine. So you can, you can assign transcoding jobs to it. So in detail, you can set a watch folder, which is basically a platform to automate the transcoding process. But you can set a watch folder with a encoding setting to encode to a set destination, and you'll be able to drop files into the folder, which will trigger an automatic transcoding to a destined location at any format that currently EDIUS supports.
So all formats which are supported right now, I can transcode to, and I can use this as a server solution. So I have some clients, and I just put some files into this engine, and they start encoding. Can I also put EDIUS projects into this transcoder?
No, right now this is a transcoder, so it only transcodes files. So basically you drop in any type of file and it'll transcode out to a set destination.
No. But there is the XRE server which is able to render projects, right?
Okay. So the XRE transcoder also has the capabilities of an EDIUS XRE, which is another, which is the previous product. So the EDIUS XRE can transcode EDIUS jobs, projects. If you send from an EDIUS client, you can send the EDIUS project to the XRE transcoder to, render the job and export out to a set destination.
And the transcoder and the server, so the transcoder includes the server.
Yes, correct. The XRE server is the actual engine that renders out. And the transcoder is the transcoding application, sorry, that allows you to set the drop watch folder and also watch the current job status and things like that.
And I've heard that the XRE is available as software, as the transcoder, including the server, but also as turnkey system?
Yes. So we provide it as software or also as a standalone turnkey, both out from Grass Valley. Yeah.
So right now this product is interesting on the one side, of course, for EDIUS users in a workspace, but it can also be used just as a dedicated encoding engine.
Correct. So we will soon release an update of the XRE transcoder that also supports ProRes encoding. So you'll be able to connect this with various types of platforms. And so we target not just the EDIUS system users, but we will also offer an SDK that will be available. So that will allow users to build systems or integrate the XRE transcoder into their system as a transcoding service.
So finally got a license from Apple to do this, because I think this is a big issue because it's a Windows machine and you really get the Apple ProRes codec to do it.
So yeah, we have gotten the certification from Apple, mm-hmm. and we will soon release an update to support ProRes encoding.
I've seen a short demo showing Stratos using as an ingest solution. So you put something, a live video signal in, and then it's transcoded. It's not really a live signal. It's a file coming from a GoPro camera, and then it's put into the transcoder watch folder. And what's happening then?
So after the file gets put into the watch folder, that triggers a transcoding process. Like in EDIUS, you will take a clip to the timeline and you will export the timeline to a file. The same process is happening inside the XRE engine and it'll export the file, in this case, into a format that is friendly in K2. So inside K2 and also Stratos, you will see that file as a growing file. So as the file gets rendered, you will see it as a growing file, and you can start playback almost immediately after you see the file inside K2.
Yeah, I was here at the demo, and it was exciting to see that there was a clip which was like 40 minutes long, and this was some file from somewhere, so not a dedicated broadcast format, put into the transcoder, and then just after seconds, he could as really play back the file, even if it's not already transcoded. I think that is quite unique, right?
Yes. So since it's using EDIUS as an engine, the speed is very fast. Exporting out to a H.264 or MPEG-2 format is actually faster than real time. So it can get to the destination, as it's being played back.
Are there some additional news for EDIUS 8?
So after version 8.5, we have plans to release an 8.5.1 soon after. Updates regarding the adjustment of audio levels based on the loudness measurement. Okay. So that will come out as 8.5.1. And the rest is coming in the future. Plan.
Okay, and I've heard that there were some inquiries about the education license and in the workgroup version, so EDIUS workgroup 8. Is there something going to happen in this area?
Yeah, so we will release a new SKU for a educational version of EDIUS workgroup based on requests from customers. Yeah. And that will be released soon, early next month.
Yeah, we had some television schools also asking for that. On the one hand side, they can buy the education license, which is much cheaper than the ordinary license, but there was just a pro version. And for those customers, the workgroup version would be good. So that's possible now.
Yeah. Yes. Okay. Yes.
So, yeah, perfect for, thank you very much for giving us the information and have a great NAB.
Yes. Thank you very much. Yes.
Thank you.